Welcome to Finance IT Course of National IT Promotion Agency, or NIPA, of Korea. I am Sang-Sung Oh, Head of International Cooperation Team at Korea Financial Telecommunications and Clearance Institute, or KFTC. It is my great honor and pleasure to be here to cover payment system of Korea as part of this course. Now let's get started from the first part. What is payment system? Likewise, government also have to provide infrastructures for financial transactions. And we call it FMI, or financial market infrastructure. According to PFMI, Principles for Financial Market Infrastructure of BIS, Bank for International Settlement, FMI is defined as multilateral system among participating institutions, including the operator of the system. And it is used for clearing, settling, and recording of payments, securities, derivatives, and the other financial transactions. And there are five types of FMIs. Among them, payment system is the first FMI. I think the reason is why payment system at the top is that payment system is the most essential and basic infrastructure for financial transactions. According to PFMI again, payment system is a set of instruments, procedures, rules for the transfer of funds among participants. It means it is not payment system, not just IT system, which is hardware or software. Instead, it is a comprehensive arrangement of multiple components. So it is usually compared to a house made up of a roof and four pillars and a foundation stone. The roof is a participant. The most typical participant is absolutely commercial banks. But as you know, nowadays, a variety of non-bank organizations like fintech companies are also participating in this system. And the four pillars are instruments, procedures, rules, and IT systems. And the foundation stone is system operator. And there are two types of payment systems. The one is a wholesale payment system, also called real-time gross settlement system, or RTGS. And the other one is retail payment system. Wholesale payment system is usually used for large value payment between financial institutions. On the other hand, retail payment system is used for low value payment transactions, usually between individual customers. And usually the wholesale payment system is operated by central bank. So in South Korea, Bank of Korea, which is a central bank of South Korea, is operating wholesale payment system in the name of BOK Wire. On the other hand, retail payment system is operated by ACH, or Automated Clearing House. In South Korea, KFTC, Korea Financial Telecommunications and Clearing Institute, is operating this retail payment system. Typically, retail payments transactions go through three steps of a process: payment, clearing, and settlement. Let me explain more in next some slides. Let's get started from payment instrument. The most traditional payment instruments, of course, cash. And cash is still being used widely all around the world. But nowadays, as you know, people are using a variety of non-cash payment instruments, such as credit card, debit card, and other mobile applications such as QR code payment. Now, Let's think about the difference in process between cash and non-cash payments instrument. When you use cash for payments, the process is very simple. Let's suppose you are buying something at shopping mall by cash. You receive something that you want to buy, and you give the amount of cash to the merchant. That's it. We don't need any more other actions to finalize these transactions. In this case, payment, clearing, and settlement happen at the same time and at the same place. Now let's think about the process when you use electronic payment instruments. So now let's suppose you are buying something at online shopping mall. When you're buying something at online shopping mall, can you use cash? No, it's impossible. You have to use non-cash payment instrument, usually electronic payment instruments. So now let's suppose you are buying something at online shopping mall with debit card. After you order something from the online shopping mall, you have to enter some information about your debit card, such as card number and PIN code. That's it? No, we need more the transactions to finalize. At first, your bank, buyer's bank, deduct the amount of money from your account, and they send the information to the seller's bank through the clearing center. And the seller's bank deposit the amount of money to the seller's bank account. And then clearing center send the clearing information to the settlement center, usually which is a central bank. And the central bank transfer the amount of money from buyer's bank to the seller's bank account. And we can divide the whole process into three parts: payment, clearing, and settlement. Now you know everything about payment system. Now let's move on to financial inclusion, especially relationship between payment system and financial inclusion. Nowadays, financial inclusion is being considered as one of the most important factors for economic growth. So, according to World Bank, financial inclusion is defined as individuals and businesses have access to useful and affordable financial products and services, such as transactions, payments, savings, credit, and insurance. From this definition, we can draw a very clear conclusion. That is, payment system is one of the most essential components for financial inclusion because it makes people send and receive payments. Let's see what happened in South Korea. In South Korea, in 1986, interbank retail payment system was launched. Since then, for 30 years, GDP of South Korea increased 13 times. During the same period, the number of interbank fund transfer increased 15 times. It shows very close relationship between payment system and economic growth. And it means payment system make a great contribution to economic growth. Thank you so much for watching.